Good morning kids, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing great at your home. I'm Khushbu Patel from Saraswati Group of Education and today I'm conducting this session for chapter number 3 in Science Explanation. Now I hope you have remembered what we have done last in this chapter and I also hope that you have done well in your exam. In the last session of this chapter, we have completed seeing the Harvard slides. I hope you have learned that. Now today we are going to start with the explanation of this chapter. So before I start the explanation, I hope you all are sitting with your textbook and a pencil so that you can underline. Right? Now open page number 31 of your textbook. What is the chapter's title? Which is Fiber to Fabric. Right? What we need to understand in this? See kids, fiber means single thread. And fabric means many threads are combined together and they are making fabric, or you can say cloth. What is that? It is fabric. Jene apne kapad kahiye chi. Right? But before we start anything, we need to understand the history of it. Right? In the ancient time, where people are wandering, they were roaming here and there in search of a food and shelter. They were not wearing clothes, right? But why clothes is necessary? It is necessary that it gives protection against different environmental conditions. That means it gives protection against heat, cold, rain, snow. We are using different type of clothes, but we are not using clothes only for covering our body or just for protecting our body. We are using different type of a fabric for bed sheets, for curtains, for handkerchief and many more things, right? So fabric is needed, or you can say it is must. But as I have told you that in ancient time, where human beings were not settled at one place, they were roaming here and there in search of a food and shelter. They never used to cover their body. They used to hide themselves in the cave if there is a condition of a rain or extreme cold. But slowly, steadily, they have understood that seasonal changes will be regular. We cannot withstand with that seasonal change. So instead of hiding ourselves in the cave, we should cover our body. And we also know that ancient humans were used to hunt the animals and they used to eat the flesh of that animals. Before the invention of fire, they were eating raw flesh, kachu mas khai jata. And after the invention of fire, they have learned to bake them and they were eating them, right? But slowly, steadily, they have also learned how to cover their body. So the skin of animals, the bark of the trees, right, the big leaves of the trees, they used to cover their body with the help of these things, right? So they have also learned that after covering their body, they are getting protection against the heat, cold and rain. But the problem was, they were not understanding, or they were not knowing actually how to sew that. But gradually and slowly they have also learned that. So in short, importance of clothes, importance of covering your body is not in the last 2-3 decades or last few years, but these importance is from the ancient time. Slowly technology has developed, science has developed. So they have learned sewing the clothes and they have started making the different type of clothes. So about all that things, we will learn in this chapter. Right? So I hope you have opened the page, that is 31 page number. Now we will start. What is the first topic? Brief history of clothing. I have given certain points related to the clothing history right now. But what is given in your textbook, that also we need to understand, right? So let us do that. See, humans always had the need to protect themselves from the natural elements like heat, cold and rain, right? We don't have a control over all these different changes, right? If you have seen in the news, you will see that in some part of the world where there is a winter, so in some part of the world there is a summer. So we cannot control this environmental changes, but we can protect our body from this condition, from this environmental condition, right? So how can we protect our body? We can protect it by wearing different type of clothes. The way we are wearing woolen clothes and leather jackets in a winter season, we are wearing cotton clothes in a summer season, we are covering our body with the raincoat in the rainy season, right? So these different type of clothes are needed, but in short, we have to protect our body from the different condition. And who is helping us in that? Clothes, right? So it is important part in our life. Okay, see here. In ancient times, the clothes were made of animal skin, fur, leaves, grasses, barks of trees, or even bones and shell, right? So they were having a different sources from which they used to cover their body. What was that sources? You can say animal skin, just because I told you that people used to hunt animal for their food requirement. So skin they can't able to eat. So what they used to do? They used to take that animal skin to cover their body, right? Then fur of the animal, we know, right, that many of the animals are having a long hairs on their body, which is known as a fur. So that fur is also used by the ancient people. Then leaves of the tree, many of the trees are having a very big leaves, like banana trees, right? So they used to cover their body with the leaves also. Then grasses, it's impossible to cover the entire body with the help of a grasses, but yes, they used to use it. Then barks of the tree, we have seen in the hardwood, the hard layer outside the stem or leaf is considered as the bark, or in short you can say bark means what? Skin of tree, right? So these were the sources for them to cover their body. There are two more options given, but we cannot consider it, that bones of the animals as well as shells of the animals, because these two are very much hard, right? So they cannot wrap the bones and the shells around their body. But yes, they used to use all this type of sources to cover their body, right? See further. After people began to settle in agricultural communities, they started weaving twigs. Now understand, what is the meaning of a twigs? Twigs means branches of tree. Twigs means what? Branches of trees, right? So no doubt they were using these things to cover their body, but unko seena nahi aata tha. So usually they used to drape it around. Usko aise aapne padhe kahin vitari deta tha khali. But after that they have started living settled life. Prior they were wandering here and there, but in a agricultural communities, matlab they were living at one place and they were doing the agricultural practices. So they were started living the settled life. After that they have also learned to weave the clothes, right? See, twigs and grasses into long strands. Strands again means long fibers, long thread, right? Or you can say piece of a fabric. Slowly they begin to weave these strands into clothes or fabric. Right? Strands means dora. Then they were using that strands to attach with each other. Right? So if one single thread will not make clothes, but if too many threads are combined together, they will make a fabric. So slowly they have also learned that how that strands can be converted into fabric or a cloth. So they have made their life much easier. Instead of just wrapping the skins and leaves of the trees, they have started sewing the clothes. They started making the different clothes and they started wearing. Right? See, they still did not know how to stitch, so they simply dragged the clothes around their body. Still, they have started learning making the clothes, but they don't know how to sew the clothes. Unko stitch kaise karna tha, they don't know. So kya karte the? Simply they used to drape it around. Potana sharir upar khali vitaadi deta tha. Right? Now see, when the people learn to make a simple needle out of animal bones, right? They used to hunt the animal. So flesh they used to eat. Skin they used to drag. But what about bones? Bones were used for different purposes. They used to make the weapons from the bones, and from that bones they have also started making a kind of an instrument which will help them to sew the clothes, which was needle. Needle means soil. They have started making the needle out of bones of the animals, which were sharp and were helping them to stitch the clothes. Right? See, they started sewing after the invention of spinning wheel. We have seen this in the hardwood. And here also you can see the photograph of a spinning wheel. With the help of that wheel, they have started stitching the clothes. Right? See here. After the invention of spinning wheel, during the industrial revolution, industrial means in a factory, revolution means sudden change, right? So spinning wheel was a change, it was a revolution, right? So it was helping them to do different type of a work. But in a textile industry means the industry who is making fabric, right? So in a textile industry, spinning wheel was used for weaving the clothes, for stitching the clothes, right? See, nearly all clothes were hand sewn. Hand sewn matlab hathe ki sivela. Right? After the invention of spinning wheels, they have started converting the strands into fabric and they have also started stitching it with the help of their hand. But just remember one thing, that they have used the needle which was made from the bones of animals. Right? See, the spinning wheel brought revolution in the world of clothing. Right? Just imagine that you are doing it with your hands and you are doing same activity with the help of machine. So in which you will do it fast, of course, in a machine. So after the invention of a spinning wheel, the clothing or the stitching of the clothes were much easier. It was made their life much easier. Right? See here. Brought revolution in the world of clothing, which eventually lead to factory. Prior, people used the spinning wheel at their home and it was running on their hands. Matlab haathe se chalao padto. Then the spinning wheel were also used in some factory which was running on electricity. That means that spinning wheel needs no human efforts. Unko human efforts ki koi zarurat nahi thi. They were working on the electricity. Right? So that is what it is, a spinning wheel, which was considered as the revolution in the clothing or textile industry. Right? Moving further. See, since then, clothing has undergone many changes over the years and several varieties, texture and colors of fabric are now available. We have seen the history of fabric, that people used these many options for covering their body. But after the invention of a spinning wheel, now we have a different type of clothes. We have cotton clothes, we have jute clothes, we have silk clothes, and we also have some artificial fabric clothes, which is polyester, nylon, and we also have a different colors, different design, different texture. Texture means when you touch, you feel difference. If you will touch the cotton clothes, you will feel that it is smooth. But if you will touch the jute bag, you will feel that it is coarse or it is rough. So different texture, different design, different material, different colors are now available. And all thanks to spinning wheel, the most revolutionary thing in the terms of a clothing industry. Right? So I hope you have understood till here. Now, see, we are going to go ahead with the next topic, which is that here in this chapter, all you know that we have to understand different things about the fabric. So first thing is to understand the types of fabric. What we will understand? Types of fabric. There are so many different types of fabric available, as I have told you: cotton, silk, polyester, jute, nylon, woolen, many. Right? So that all we are covering here. But where do we get this from? What are the main sources? That also we have to cover. But before we start that, we need to understand types of fabric. Right? See here. We all wear clothes every day. Right? We wear clothes. If we are not wearing it, people will say that this person is totally mad. Right? So clothes are important. It is not only for the protection. Right? But we are not allowed to go naked in the society, in the public area. So we have to cover our body with the clothes. So clothes are most important thing. Just imagine if somebody is just running without clothes. How do you feel? Right? So clothes are important. See, but have you ever stopped to think how many important moments and everyday experiences in our life are associated with some form of fabric? Some, you know, we are wearing different clothes, but some clothes are very dear to us, very near to our heart. If I say your birthday clothes, your blanket, your softer which is having a fur. So some clothes are such that you like the most, and maybe you save it for your entire life. Right? So in short, clothes are necessary and we need to use it for the protection. Right? Protection against different environmental condition. Right? See here. From our childhood, blanket to our birthday dresses, and from our school uniform to beautiful curtains in our bedroom, fabric plays a major role. We are not using clothes or a material for just making the clothes, but we are also using fabric for different purposes, like curtains, bed sheets, cushion covers, rugs. Right? In short, clothes are important. Material, or you can say fabric, is important. Right? See further. Fabric protect us from cold, heat, rain and dust. That we have seen in the starting only, that clothes are important to cover, but it is not only important to cover the body, but it is also important that it is giving protection against different type of condition like rain, dust, heat, cold, snow, storm. Right? See, we use blanket to keep ourselves warm in a winter season when there is too much cold. Right? You are just covering yourself with the help of a blanket. You will never like to come out from it. Right? Because why? It is giving us warmth. Right? See, and woven rugs. Rugs means what? When you enter to anyone's house, at the doorstep, you can see something is kept on which you are wiping your legs, which is known as rugs. So rugs are also we are using. We are also using that rugs to keep under our sofa, right? See, rugs to cushion our steps as we walk. On the steps also, at some offices you can see, especially when you are going to a banquet hall and when you are climbing the stairs, you can see that the stairs are covered with certain clothes. Then we call carpet. What is that? It's a rugs. It's a woven clothes, right, which is covering the step on which we are climbing up. So clothes are not only important for making the clothes for humans, but it is also important for many other things, right? See, are all these made up of one same material? If I say that the curtains material and your cloth material is the same, is it true? The material of your mother's sari and the material of your father's shirt, is it same? No, it is not same. All the materials are different from each other, right? See, no, each fabric gives a different look and feel, right? When you are wearing certain clothes on certain occasion, it is not the regular clothes which you are wearing at your home, right? So every material has its own characteristic. It has its own color and own texture and its own feel. We cannot wrap the bed sheet around our body, or we cannot just spread our t-shirt on the bed. So every fabric has its own importance, but the material is different from each other, right? So that is considered as what? Types of a fabric, right? If you will touch the woolen clothes and if you will touch the leather clothes, you can feel the difference, right? Because all the materials will have their own characteristic, right? So that all we are going to cover here. Now kids, today what you will do at home? You will collect some pieces of cloth. That doesn't mean that you will cut one piece from your mother's sari and one piece from your father's shirt and one piece from your sibling's cloth. No, right? Any unused cloth, jo koi use nahi karta, unused matlab naya wala nahi. Just collect the different materials of cloth and touch it. Just see that what you feel. Can you feel the difference? Right? Yes, you will feel the difference. Right? And just note down that observation in your textbook somewhere. Right? Where you find the place, or you can write it in your rough book. Fine. So here, today I am ending my session. We have just done the history of a clothing and types of fabric today. I hope you have understood. Today you are going to read the topic which we have covered. And for any query, you will go through this video again. In the next session, we are going to start with the most important part of this chapter, that is sources of fiber and types of fiber. Right? So today I am taking your leave. I hope you have understood and you have enjoyed. We'll meet next time. Bye bye.